Hey, Dana here, and welcome to my blog, and this is a continuation of getting the 96 Ford Mustang running again after the engine change, and under the topic of white smoke. Well, right now what I'm doing is I've got some old intake bolts, and I'm cutting them off so I can use them as guides. So I'm going to put the gaskets on there aligned and then go ahead and slide the intake on there and then get it bolted. So cutting those off and then putting a slit in the middle here so I can use a flathead screwdriver to screw them back out. Okay, here we go. Got my little slots cut into these. I got one left to do. Using a Sawzall, I thought I was going to use the cutting wheel, but it didn't work as well as I was hoping it did. So we're going to go ahead and get this cut down or slitted. All right, get them all set. Let's get them in the heads. Let's get these squeezed in there. So I don't have to worry. Be able to align these. No problem. Cut from the end. Let me slide one. Go on. That's right. I need thread cleaners. I should have thread cleaners. I don't have any. Send these in. Just send those thread in there first. Because now I have got my guide pins. Make sure the threads are as clean as you can get them. Actually, your guide holes should be the same way. When you go to torque it down, you're not going to get the correct torque. I was looking around for that bolt all this time, and the darn thing's actually over here. So you got one. Got this one on the back side, which is going to hold that DMS bracket is on the back side, so that's got to be there. And then you've got the other one on the front side. That's going to be, because they have something that they're holding. Nut for that one. And another nut here. Two. Okay. So those are one, two, other things, so make sure you get them in the right place. All right. We gotta get my act together when it comes to torquing these. Because you're putting your sealant on there, and that sealant's gonna dry really, really quick. All right. And you also have your torquing. Here's your torquing sequence on all of them. As you're looking at it, that's for your V8. For your V8, and this is for the V6. One's going to be in the middle. And you got to go across. One, two. One, two, three, and then four, and then you're gonna jump over to five, six, seven, then eight, across nine, back down to 10, and jump back up to 11, 12, 13, and 14. So you're all over the place. I gotta see if they're not all torqued the same. Okay. And then here's your intake manifold, your cylinder head bolts later. So we're gonna go 72 inch pounds or 6 foot pounds. See, I've been here before. And then step two, you're gonna take it to 9 foot pounds, which isn't much at all. It's a little boring. Got my Pittsburgh tap and die kit. And I found the proper die. So now what I'm doing is I'm running the threads through it to clean them up. Sure, I got no sealant. You want a smooth torquing if you can get one. So you want to chase the threads. You want to clean these threads up on your bolts. Get all the crap off of them. You want a smooth torque. If you got a resistance torque, it's going to be torqued to whatever that restrictive side of the house is. It's just, you know, it's something you want to do. Sure, all your threads are clean. Oh, it's kind of. They don't make me happy. I'm gonna get a wrench real quick. Shouldn't take that. Take a look. Yeah, well, did it before me. Use a lot of silicone on this. I've already gone through the ziz wheel and cleaned up all the surfaces. Already taken some. Yeah, I got a spare one over there. I'm not going to use this one. This is already started. Because of the hard water or whatever was in the antifreeze, it's already started eating through that bolt. Just so happens the 94 down there that I swapped the engines out of, somebody had already taken the motor out of it and thrown all the valve guides and all the bolts and everything from the heads and all that stuff down there in a box. So it's just coincidental enough that it was the same, the motor was the same between these two. So this is definitely this motor is out of a 94 or 95. Clean of the beta. Okay, now I gotta find the thread chaser.
that.
All right, so rumors I can't find the thread chaser in that, so I just use a nice clean bolt and go down through and make sure they're finger tight, or you know, I'm able to rotate the bolt with my fingers. All right, so we're at that point. Let's get the gaskets on here and get this intake on. I gotta check the O-rings on the, get everything, I'm gonna get all the gaskets on there and then get it ready to put the intake on there. I gotta clean the, probably gotta change the O-rings on the fuel injectors. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 6. Guys out there. Should roll right up over it. Yep. All right, let's go. Dick? Broke it. That's good. Pissed it and broke it. There we go. Yeah. Yeah. This one's missing that cap. I guess it don't matter. Okay. So it gives you six of those into the fuel injection. I expect you to pull the ones out of them. Okay. Black quarter bead at sealant four corners. Okay. All right, we're running now. So right now it says home in front alignment studs, which I just did, apply at quarter of the YD bar TV sealant at the four corners where the manifold is going to hook into. It's got 24 hours. Let me see. Done 15 minutes, but this is a slower sealant. Okay. Okay, we just did that. Did you see me do that? Okay, good. Apply a dab of contact adhesive manifold gasket mating surface on each cylinder. Okay. Apply. We'll see. Let's see. How many seals? Okay, still. Apply a small dab of contact adhesive or gasket mating surface. Okay, so we're just going to go on the basically just to hold the gasket in place. And okay, roll. It says top. Make sure you put the top. Get your alignment bolts. Oh shit. Okay. Alright. I'm a little more. One more on that at the corner there. Takes a plug into. Okay, now we'll go ahead and put her. Because you're really allowing the gasket to do the job here. Okay. Okay, take your sealant.
Okay.
You do that again. Oh, Rosie?
Mama.
Oh, Mama? Okay.
We do, baby.
Okay.
Now go in that garage and get into anything.
Your ends again.
You're okay.
All right. Now, here we go. A little bit of engine oil. On those.
So we're getting there.
Yep.
All right.
Some engine oil over the O-rings. Putting this on.
Let's get these guide bolts up. No, they're not being my friend. They say the guide bolt, put the guide bolts in, the guide bolts in, the guide bolts in. And they're not helping me at all. God. Man. Yeah, do it this way, do it this way. Well, sometimes it doesn't work. Dang it. Freaking crap, all my freaking sealant. Start over. Now you watch your alignment on your gaskets. Alright, I'm gonna reseal these. Alright, let's try to get it back on there. Okay. All right, here we go. Scratch the surface because of the. Gotta be careful with those damn guides if you're gonna use them. Get that stuff out of the way. Get out of the way. You line it up your fuel injectors, the holes. Head in the right direction. Down. Okay. Beautiful. That's that one. Right down the line. This one here is a. Two more. Beautiful.
Beautiful. It's pain. My balls. I want to see what I'm doing. Yeah, it's definitely going to be of advantage to try to move through. Girls out of the way. I got one more. Come back there. Well, the intake's on. It's snug. I'm missing my blue socket. When I find my blue socket, I'll be back to it. Alright, I've done my first initial torquing on it. So the next torque is going to be my final one. I was just using the one more torque on it, we're good. Nine foot pound, 108. Basically, what I got this one at. Like the minimum this thing goes is freaking 120. So I got that locked. I got that locked at that right now. So one. And that's on that One is on this side here, on your right side, and it's the fourth one over. So one, two, three, four. I don't know if this will even break. It'll break off of that. Alright, it's tight. And straight across from it, these two. I don't like it. I can't tell how it's gonna break. Three. Coming back from the bat. One, two, and that's three. One under here. Three, okay. The one I was hitting. Three. Four. On this side. Three up. Two. Here. Thing is, I'm probably getting this torqued. You need a micro torque wrench to do this. Okay, that's 20. All right, where was I? I was doing five. So third one up. One, two, three, four. This would be five. I'm already at 20 on that. Six, three from the back. One, two, one here. Okay. Second one. 10. 13. Basically covers them all. Torque them all on a freaking. Get on that. I need to get a micro torque wrench. Okay. All right. I saw it before the car. All right, we're done. Out of pain. Stuff needs to be on the bench. All right.